Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling a little bit satisfied with myself because I'm nearing the end of a big project, which was redesigning my website in WordPress, which you see running right now. We're almost at the end of it, and I thought maybe we could take a few minutes and talk about WordPress design, how you go about building a website. And for a lot of you, this might be your first kind of peek at the back end of websites, at the inner workings and the control room behind the websites that we visit on a regular basis. So today, a little look at WordPress on Dotto Tech. WordPress is one of several different platforms that allow people to create websites. Now, WordPress has people get confused with WordPress because there's WordPress that you install yourself on a server that you install on a server. And WordPress also has kind of a self-administered website that they host and they manage all of the stuff for kind of entry-level type stuff, more really for blogging, for just creating blogs. We're going to be talking about the first instance where you've got a proper WordPress installed, you have your own server, and you are doing it and it's set up for real business. Now, I have just finished redesigning my site, which I know needed it desperately. And like everything else, I just kind of rolled up my sleeves and dove right in head first to see, not really too much worried about what I didn't know, kind of more worried about what I could learn. And I'm pretty pleased with the results. So if you know, let's just quickly look at it right now and then let's jump into the back end of it so that you can see all of the different pieces and you can understand what goes into composing a website and preparing it. So this is the site. So what I wanted is I wanted something that, you know, just created the energy and kind of the confidence of what Dotto Tech is all about, maybe some competence, a level of competence detached. So I talk about the fact that, you know, we're going to teach you about productivity and technology solutions, promote my keynotes, my speaking a little bit. And then we get into the actual videos, all of the different videos that I produce. Now for my site, the main content is videos that I produce that we host here on YouTube, but that we present on our own site. Most websites have a composition of pages and then posts. And posts are kind of sub-pages within a larger infrastructure. The overall hierarchy of your website is very important as you design it, and it's something that you're going to pay a lot of attention to. And the more closely you follow rules relating to the structure of your website, the more efficient your website is going to be in a variety of different ways, and the easier it's going to be for you to manage it. So these are my posts, and I've got posts in different areas. I've got my regular demo posts, which this will be one. I've got the Ask Dotto Tech posts. I've got my vlog, which is growing your YouTube channel, so you can see them all there. Then there's the marketing side of my website, because we do have to make some money, where we promote our courses and let people know about our courses. And then at the very bottom here, we see a little bit of what we call social proof. This is a tool that talks about how often our blogs and our pages are being shared and talked about in social media. Because at the end of the day, people visiting your site on the internet are nothing but lemmings. Sorry to say it, but it's true. We don't look at something of value unless somebody else online tells us that it's value. We don't trust our own eyes. So this idea of social proof, of having lots of tweets, lots of Facebook shares, lots of likes attached to all of our content, adds to the value of the content, regardless of how good the content is. If it's got lots of likes and lots of shares, people think it's good. And if it is good and has lots of likes and shares, so much the better. So this is what it looks like to you and I visiting the website. What did it look to me like as I was building it, and how do I manage it? Well, this is the WordPress dashboard. This is my site, but from the back looking out. And you see down the left-hand side here, all of the different tools that are within WordPress that allow us to control it. Now, everybody's basic set of tools are gonna be different, but most people have the same sort of tools running. When you install WordPress, you're gonna get a predefined set of different tools available for you, and they allow you to manage the pages and manage the posts. But on top of all of this, you're going to install what's called a theme. A theme sets all of the global settings for WordPress. Now, I use a theme called Themify. Let me just call them up here, because you should know about Themify, because I quite like Themify. So Themify is actually a good Canadian company, as one would expect. It's coming from me. And Themify is a company that they do Shopify. They do the big shopping cart tool, but they also have all of these different themes available. They have premium WordPress themes. And so you can sign up and you can purchase a license for an individual theme or for a collection of all of their themes, which is what I did. And it cost like $79 a year for me to access all of their themes. And they're constantly tweaking them because WordPress itself is constantly changing. But this is just the beginning. I think you can be fooled into thinking that when you look at something like this, you're there and you've got your site done, but it's not actually the case. This is the theme that I use on my site. It's called Ultra. And if we take a look at how it looks when they show it, it looks quite a bit different. If you look at it, looks pretty good, actually. It looks very different, I would say, than mine. Yet it's got a lot of the same common elements. It's got, what this is actually called a parallax type site, which we have actually kind of two layers. You have a background photo layer or an image layer, and then you have a foreground active layer, which is pretty cool. It creates this nice slide over, which I think gives it a certain je ne sais quoi, a certain elegance to it. But at any rate, so I installed that theme, and then you start poking around and changing things within the theme. Now, I think if you're a real website designer, that you've got a strategy behind it all, and you know exactly what you're doing going in. Not so for Dotto, I'm afraid to say. Instead, what happened was I basically cloned my whole site over onto a development site, played around, tried different things out, and learned how this theme worked, and basically just cobbled it together myself. I'm sure it's not the most efficient way to do it. Consequently, it took me a couple of months to do it, but I got it done the way I wanted it. I got it done right, and I learned a lot of things along the way. So let me just take you through some of these different tools so you can understand exactly what each piece is. So within WordPress itself, we've got the ability to have posts and pages, as I mentioned before. So pages are the big things, like the home page is a page. If we go in and we take a look at my speaking page, that where I talk about, where I promote my speaking business, that is a page because this content is fairly static. You can have dynamic content within it, but it's fairly static and it's kind of almost like chapters if you think about books. Within the pages themselves, you can have different posts, and the blog posts can be in different categories. So if we go in and we take a look at back to the homepage here, we can see that I've got a link here which will bring you into all of my vlogs. This is what I call my posts. And so here's all of my different demos that we've produced recently. So you can go in and you can see each of these is what's called a post. They're not a page, but they're a post. So if we go into it, it will look like a page when we're into it, but it's actually got some different features and a different way of being served and a different way of being classified so that it automatically populates. Here's what I mean by that, and this is a big deal. When I finish this video that we're looking at right now, we will create a blog post based around this video. Once that blog post is created, we will create it as a post within WordPress. And then once it's published, it will automatically replace this one right here. I don't have to go in and manually say, here's the newest one. But instead, because I will have classified it as a Dotto demo, which is what I call my demo videos or what I call my demo posts, it will automatically populate in here. And once it's this one here has been moved from here, it'll get moved down to here because I've got the second one in the series running here. As soon as I create a new Ask Dotto Tech and we post it and we publish it, it will automatically usurp this Dotto Tech episode 18 here with episode 19. So you just create content and then it automatically flows onto the pages and is properly served out to people. If we want to take a look at all of the different Dotto's Ask Dotto Tech shows, we can just go here into the page that I created that has all of the posts collected. And again, as those posts get published, they'll automatically be populated onto this page. So it's very low. Once you're more concerned, once you set up your WordPress site, about the content than you are about structure, because you've set all of the structure up in this initial design phase, if that makes sense. So going back to the WordPress install, we see that we have the posts available here, and down here are pages. Now, also pages can be used for things like landing pages and opt-in pages for webinars and other things, but we'll get into that some other time. Within the posts themselves, though, there's some different features that we look for, because if you think about what you want in a WordPress site, or any website, you want to have the ability to communicate and convey the valuable information that you have and you're offering out there. But then you also want to create some sort of mechanism for engagement with your audience. Now, that can be chat. That could be some sort of forum where people have a conversation, which can be somewhat problematic. I've never had a lot of success with allowing conversations to happen on my website because it seems to be a very popular place for hackers and stuff to attack. Although there are some systems that work very well for comments, instead, I leave my comments in Facebook and in YouTube, and that's where I have a dialogue. So if I don't have comments, what sort of interaction can I have on my site? Well, what I aim for is to get people to subscribe to my newsletter, ultimately on my site. Watch my videos, read my content, and subscribe to my newsletter. That's what I look for. So I've created opt-ins on every page that are, again, automatically created. So when we compose a post, let's just go into a post here, and I'll show here, I'll bring up a list of all of our posts. And when we go in and we actually edit the post itself, well, I'll click here on edit, you'll see here that we have a whole bunch of different tools. And this might look a little bit confusing to you on the surface, but you will very quickly learn how what all of these different pieces are, because there's a lot of moving parts in a WordPress blog post. There's the content itself, there's the engagement, and then there's also all of the search engine optimization that has to happen so that it can be found and properly classified on the internet. So within this, because I'm using this Themify theme, we actually, typically speaking, when you're in WordPress, you would think that you'd be entering your content here into the main text field, but there's a slightly different way that we enter information here as we go along. But before we get to the content, let's show you some of the extra interactive pieces and then get back to the content, if you'll stay with me. The first thing that we see here, this is something called a plugin which I've installed, which is Social Warfare. Now, WordPress by itself is fairly vanilla. It will allow you to post video, it'll allow you to post posts, create pages, have some interactivity in those pages, have hyperlinks within them, graphics, maybe embed a video, but it doesn't allow for things like pulling in all of the different social media markers that you have out there, automatically creating like buttons, say from Facebook. All of that comes from something called plugins, where we add and we extend the functionality of WordPress. This Social Warfare is just such a plugin. And what Social Warfare does is it manages all of the different social networks that I want to create connections to within a post. So within this, I've set global settings for WordPress and for all of my social networks. And the way that it resolves is if we go here and let's just watch this, go into this blog post here, is it is represented by those icons that we were showing you on the homepage. They also appear here on the blog post pages themselves. And if we scroll down, we'll see a representation of all of the different social networks that I'm currently active in. Now, what the encouragement and the idea here is I want people to click on those if they like the post so that I can, I want people to click on those if they like the post so that they create that social proof. So other people see that other people have, that the people that have viewed this before them like it and have kind of given it their seal of approval. And so everybody else is going to figure this is great. So when we go into the post, we see here all the social icons coming from Social Warfare. Now, this is all created with a connection within WordPress where I tell them what my Facebook page is, what my Twitter account is, and you can see that there's been 38 actions with this in the last day or so. So when somebody visits this page now, what'll happen is they'll see that there's been 38 people, 32 people have liked it, or 33 have liked it on Facebook. So immediately, it's got some credibility because people are already saying that it's valuable. Now, depending on how much traffic you have to your website, this might be a minuscule or a massive number of different likes and clicks and tweets and that sort of stuff. For me, this is great. 38 in a day or so means that there's lots of traffic on this, as far as I'm concerned, and people like it, and they're giving me kind of kudos by clicking on it. Now, the nice thing about Social Warfare is I didn't create this very cool thing of having this stark background, and then when you roll over, it becomes color. All of those are settings that I set within Social Warfare. So I married that look to the overall look of my site, and we came up with something that I think really works well for my WordPress site. These are the little things, these are the little touches that you can add to WordPress that make it special for you. So we'll see that WordPress plugin at the top, and we'll also see it down here at the bottom of each and every post. Now, right beneath that is another plugin, and this one is from a tool called Opt-in Monster. And this one here, it helps me create and generate people opting in and signing up for my newsletter. Now, again, when we create a post, we don't have to create this opt-in form on every post. Oh, no, no, no. Instead, we've created a rule by using Opt-in Monster and plugging it into WordPress. And if we go over into WordPress, back into WordPress, down here we will find Opt-in Monster right there as a tool available to us. We've created this rule so that it automatically goes into every post that we create and it's positioned where we want it to in each post. Now, this could also be a pop-up window that pops up. You can set it up for 5 seconds after people visit a site, and you'll see it often. It'll say, do you want to sign up for my newsletter or do you want some free information on this? This always encourages people to sign up for some free giveaway or some newsletter so that you can capture that information and then store it in your email autoresponder so that you can then talk to the people later and kind of bring them into your community. So these are the mechanisms that make WordPress work from a social media marketing perspective. As I go through the rest of the, some of the other tools within here, we've got the ability to manage our plugins here. If we go down towards the bottom of it, I've got another tool here called Pretty Link. Where's my Pretty Link? There it is. Pretty Link, which allows me to modify exactly what the URLs or what these addresses look like and make them far more user-friendly and also track what's going on. But the bottom line is WordPress is an environment that allows us to manage the user experience down to the minute detail. And the more time you spend mastering each of the different aspects of WordPress, the better off you're going to be as far as making sure that your site is performing the way you want. Now, one thing before I leave this is one of the things that I looked for before I chose this particular theme, if we go back here to the themes within Themify, is I made sure that this theme was something called responsive, meaning that it will resolve and it will work well in a mobile environment. And indeed, this site looks great in a mobile environment because probably as many as 50% of our visits now to our website are coming from people on their smartphones. So you've got to make sure that the site will convert itself and automatically modify its display for the mobile environment. WordPress it's sort of like, I guess back in the day when you had Microsoft Word and we had PageMaker and Quark Express, we had these page layout tools. It's like the PageMaker and Quark Express in the early desktop publishing days. It's an important skill for you to learn. If you don't learn how to manage all of WordPress yourself, you can still have somebody else design your WordPress site and you can go into it on a regular basis and you can simply edit all of the different posts yourself, which is quite simple to do. So it's like working with Word within those environments. It's like working with a word processor. But I think the more you know about the inner workings of WordPress, the better off you're going to be able to take advantage of those tools. And for those of you who never have a website, understanding how they work in the background, I think, helps you as well when you visit sites to understand why people are doing things at different times and why something is suddenly popping up on your screen. Understanding the mechanisms that it's trying to address might be helpful as well. Well, that's it. This was a little bit of a long ramble. I hope you found it to be enlightening and entertaining and educational. There are three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. The second, as I was mentioning earlier, subscribe to our newsletter. We'd love to get you there so that you can come and visit us when we give free tutorials, webinars, seminars, and courses. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. It's supported through the generosity of the people who watch this channel through the crowdfunding site Patreon. I would encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, have a look, and discover what perks are available to you should you decide to support Dotto Tech. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.